and a bygone name in toys has returned, and just in time for the holidays. A year after closing all its stores, Toys R Us is back, sort of. It's a very different version of the store we once knew, but familiar nonetheless. Courtney Reagan takes us inside.
Toys R Us is back, kind of. It's a new company, but with that same familiar name. The toy retailer filed bankruptcy in 2017, failed to reorganize, liquidated, and closed all 800 stores last year. But a new parent company, True Kids, now owns the Toys R Us, Babies R Us, and Jeffrey brands, using the well-known names to start over.
It's different when you get to come here and experience it yourself and see the toys. It's just so much fun.
This is the first new Toys R Us store under the new brand owners here in Paramus, New Jersey at the Garden State Plaza Mall. Open just in time for the Black Friday shopping rush, but you won't find any doorbusters here. A second location is opening in Houston, Texas next week. Only a total of 10 planned stores will be open by the end of 2020, much smaller than the former 800 store footprint of the old Toys R Us. Also, these stores are considerably smaller, only 6,500 square feet compared to 40,000.
It's more like a boutique sort of feeling, a little more intimate, less so commercial, which I think is like a great approach.
The new Toys R Us stores are done in partnership with retail technology firm Beta, powering both what shoppers see and the behind-the-scenes systems. It's meant to be more experiential than inventory-based, with interactive displays and hands-on toy play. There are 40 toy brands here, including Hasbro, Lego, VTech, and others, many with dedicated shop-in-shops. True Kids CEO Richard Berry was formerly the chief merchant for Toys R Us. He had to convince toy makers that this time around, it will be different.
Nobody was happy with what went on and the fact that our partners were in a position where they lost money as a result of the bankruptcy. The business model is different. We had to convince brands about the business model, but it was not difficult to get this store actually oversubscribed.
Another key difference, the new Toys R Us doesn't have its own e-commerce business. If you want to buy toys you see on ToysRUs.com, you'll get redirected to Target.com, which fulfills the order. Ironic, as Target is one of the retailers that's benefited most from the absence of Toys R Us, and now its resurgence. Target added more space for toys in stores, increased toy inventory, including new Disney shops, and it's working. Credit Suisse estimated Target grabbed 15 to 20% of the Toys R Us, Babies R Us share in 2018. Toys were among Target's strongest categories in the most recent quarter, with 21 straight quarters of sales growth. While the new Toys R Us is drastically different than the original, the joy the toy store brings to many is back in time for Christmas. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Courtney Reagan in Paramus, New Jersey.